Welcome to Unit 4 PSA Time and Expense Management Introduction Video. As you can see, I'm in a dashboard of employee control. And as a team member of a project, I can directly see how much revenue I bring into the company based on a month or a quarter, and what type of expenses I book into the PSA suite. Now we are going to book time using our Outlook calendar. We will also book time, the timesheet line entry. We will do an instant time entry on the project itself, and we can do a time entry via the mobile device. That's not included in this video, it will be a separate video. So we start out with the timesheet calendar. I have planned my appointments with my clients in my Outlook agenda. Therefore, I can use my Outlook agenda as a blueprint and directly click on Outlook Retrieval and retrieve my appointments in my timesheet for review. You can see that I have a lunch with John on my project. I can evaluate the information and I can book my time to the assigned task to me. I will only book an hour because that's suggested, but maybe the lunch took me 2 hours that I'm going to book. I apply the item type, which I want to book my time against. This hour type is the partner hour type. And I have a lunch with John. We're not going to bill it. We click on save and we save the information. Now this is directly stored into the project, utilizing my budget as we go. Now I can also allocate the second appointment I have. This is for the same project, the M&A request for ideas. I can now also say the planning with the meeting client has evolved and I'm going to book some additional time to recap with the information that I have internally on the project. So now I'm going to book as a manager, right? So this is the recap on documents. I click on save. While I do this, if I traveled, I can also book my mileage. In this demo scenario, it's not included to book expenses as mileage and other expenses. So click on save, save the information. This is directly allocated to the project. If you want to utilize a specific appointment, for example, you did some preparations, you don't have it in your Outlook appointment, but when you want to copy and paste that information, you can do that directly. So you can open it, you can say, well, maybe I did some preparations. Click on save and book the time. Now, in this instance, we have booked 3 time entries using our Outlook agenda. If you want to do it manually, of course, that can be the case by simply drag and drop a time frame and do the same steps as I did before. I can also use the instant time line entry, which provides me in a split screen time entry as well as expense entry in one screen. You can also use your Outlook retrieval so that all your appointments will be retrieved directly into your timesheet. Next option is that I can pin directly a project and use that pin project to book my time and expense. So when I open my project that I work on, I can directly go into the instant time entry. This opens outside the project and I can directly start a timer. So while I might be on a telephone call with John or one of his teammates, I can now directly book time and you can see the timer running. Once I activate my timer, I can pause the timer or I can open the timer. I will open the timer and we can dive directly into the information. Applying my role, I'm booking time as a senior. I'm going to stop the timer. I'm going to slightly adjust the minutes. Adjusting a couple of minutes here, 5 minutes, and save the hour booking. Now what we did in this introduction video is that we booked time using the Outlook calendar, the timesheet line entry, the instant time entry, and we are now utilizing the budget. To directly see what we done on the project, we can go and navigate to the performance report. We can see our time allocated to this project and to the budget, and we can directly visualize that information in a screen, telling us that we're overutilizing the budget here as we go. So this concludes the introduction video of Unit 4 PSA Time and Expense Management.